Hello friends, today we will discuss CRO. Now, first of all, what is the full form of CRO? Now, as the worker can see in the screen, that the full form of CRO is cathode ray oscilloscope. Okay, now the second point about the CRO is, full form is cathode ray oscilloscope, and second point is, it is a laboratory instrument used mostly in laboratory purpose for display measurement analysis waveform. That means whatever the waveform we want to see or measure certain parameter out of the waveform, that is being investigated by this instrument in the laboratory purpose. Now third point about the CRO is, it is a very fast XY plotter. That means whatever waveform we want to see in the CRO, all of you can see in the CRO that waveform being plotted here. So this is your x-axis and this is your y-axis. So CRO is a very fast x-y plotter displaying the input signal versus time, and most of the time the default x-axis is regarded as time. Now the third point, the stylus of this plotter. Stylus of this plotter means all of you can see that when the CRO plotted the waveform, there is a stylus which moves like that over the skin, and whenever the speed of the stylus is very fast, then our eye will see a static waveform. That means whenever the CRO plotted the waveform over and over again at a very fast rate, then our eye see a static waveform in the CRO. Now this stylus moves over the skin to get our waveform, which can be visible in our eye. So that the stylus of this plotter is very important, which plotted the input waveform under investigator. Now this is a luminous spot which moves over the display area in response to input voltage. Then this plotter or the stylus is moves with response to the input voltage over the skin, which traces the waveform along the skin. Now all of this phenomenon is associated with some light phenomenon. Okay, now this stylus is actually is electron beam. Now electron beam is actually very lightweight. First of all, it is very lightweight, so that it can move very fast in the skin or over the skin. And the mechanism of this plotter is the stylus of the plotter is that this electron beam, I have said that the stylus is actually the electron beam which is lightweight. What is the main advantage? It can move very fast over the skin. And second point is, this electron beam is striking the skin, which is actually phosphorus skin. So a light is being generated after striking the waveform or striking the electron beam into the phosphorus skin, fluorescent skin. Electron and very lightweight, so response is very high. So all of that phenomenon is that the electron beam is being generated from some cathode ray tube, and it is striking the waveform as made of phosphorus. The skin is made of phosphorus actually. Now whenever the electron beam striking the phosphorus skin, the light is being generated, and that light we can see which traces over the skin. Now CRO uses two input voltage. First input voltage is your horizontal voltage, which is a ramp voltage, which is internally generated. Okay, and second voltage is which is voltage which you want to measure, that is the applied at the vertical input terminal. Okay, now this electron beam or the stylus of this plotter is actually moves horizontally with the effect of this horizontal ramp voltage, and it's moved vertically due to the effect of this vertical voltage. So we can set this plotter anywhere in the skin, okay, due to this combined effect, two of waveform combined effect with respect to time. Now CRO can measure the waveform for a very low frequency from 20 hertz to a very high frequency, maybe 1 gigahertz, and nowadays it can measure up to 20 gigahertz or so. It's a very high quality CRO which can measure 20 gigahertz. Next is cathode ray tube. Now the cathode ray tube is cathode ray oscilloscope is consist of a cathode ray tube. All of you can see that the this is the waveform is the cathode ray tube. Now cathode ray tube is consist of electron gun assembly This is your electron gun assembly. Second is your deflection plate assembly. This is your deflection plate. Okay. Next, fluorescent skin. This is your fluorescent skin or the phosphorus skin. And glass envelope. And this is your glass envelope. And next, base. This is your base. Now, this is the main parts of the CRT. Next, the electron gun assembly. This, what is the function of this electron gun assembly? Now, the electron gun assembly, this is your electron gun assembly. You can see that this is your electron gun assembly. The electron gun assembly produces sharply focused beam of electrons, which accelerated to high velocity. Thus, focused beam of electrons strike the fluorescent skin with sufficient energy to cause a luminous spot on the screen. Okay, now this is a indirectly heated cathode. The electron beam is generated from here. Next is your grid, next is your focusing anode, and next is your accelerating anode. So all of this electron gun assembly, electron from this electron gun assembly, electrons are being generated from here and moves at a very high rate, and this focusing anode focuses the electron beam to a particular plot, particular area into the skin, and this accelerating anode accelerated the electron at a very high speed. Okay, and that from the electron gun assembly, electron is being generated at a very high speed. Next is your deflection plate assembly. Now, after leaving the electron gun at a very high speed, electron beam passes through two pairs of electrostatic deflection. Two pairs of electrostatic deflection, as I have said that there are two input voltages associated with CRO. First one is your horizontal ramp voltage. Okay, and second one is your voltage that is applied at the vertical terminal, which causes the plot vertically up and down. Okay, and this horizontal voltage causes the beam move horizontally, and this vertical voltage under investigation causes the beam move vertically. Okay, now after leaving the electron gun, electron beam passes through these two pair of electrostatic deflection plates. First one is your horizontal deflecting plate, and second, which associated with horizontal voltage, and second one is your vertical deflecting plate, which associated with the vertical voltage, which is the voltage under investigation. Now, as I have said that voltage applied to one pair of plate moves the beam vertically up and down, and other pair, that is horizontally, moves the beam horizontally, which these two movements are independent of each other. Okay. Next, moving forward to the electron gun. Electron gun is actually which produces the beam of electron, which consists of a cathode. Now, the specification is very much high, that like the electrical specification, like the current is 300 milliampere, voltage is also very high, 6.3 volt, control low power design, other thing is there, there is a control grid is there. So all of the, and also as you can all of you can see that there is a intensity button and the CRO. Now the intensity button is being controlled by this control grid in the electron gun assembly. And in the electron gun assembly, there is two anode, which pre-accelerating anode, and other is accelerating anode, which moves the electron beam at a very high rate. Now, the pre-accelerating anode voltages may be as high as 1500 volt, and the focusing anode voltage is as high as 15500 volt. Okay, and next is your electrostatic deflection arrangement. Now this is your electrostatic deflection arrangement. As you can see this, this is your electrostatic deflection arrangement. That means whatever may be the electron, this is your vertical deflecting plate. Okay, now this arrangement, we have assumed that the general arrangement, this is the general arrangement for electrostatic deflection, and here there is two parallel plate, potential applied between them, there is the two parallel plate with the potential applied between them, and this plate produces the uniform electrostatic field in y direction. We have assumed there is a field associated with the y direction only. And here we have assumed that there is no force either in x direction and z direction. So here we want to see that how the electron can be moved under the application of a deflecting voltage which is applied at the y input terminal. Now that different term is associated with that, first term is here E0 is actually your voltage of the pre-accelerating anode. Next is your charge of an electron, which is, as you can see, that here is a derivation of that E0 voltage of the pre-accelerating anode, charge of an electron, mass of an electron. Vx is the voltage of an electron, which is this is voltage of an velocity of an electron and entering into the deflecting plate. Next, Ed is the potential difference between them. Next is distance between the deflecting plate in meter. This is the distance, and there is LD distance. Okay, this is your L distance, and this is the parabolic movement associated within this deflecting plate. After that, it'll move straight line. Electron move parabolically in within this deflecting plate area, then it moves in a straight line. Okay, now there is some sort of derivation. You can see that there is a potential energy when electron move from accelerating anode cathode to anode. There is a loss of potential energy, that is E into Ea. Next is, this is your gain of kinetic energy, that is half mvox square. Next, from these two we can say that this is your vox. Now the velocity of the electron in x direction, same throughout the deflecting plate, there is no force acting in the y direction. So electric field intensity, this is the electric field intensity, y direction, voltage divided by distance, force is charge into electric field intensity, Fy, force. This is the classical force equation from the Newton's law, m into Ay, Ay into this. So y equal to, you can see that after equating this, we can get that. Now the it is a parabolic movement, I have said this is a parabolic movement, so this is your parabolic movement equation. Okay, as you replace the Ay, this is the equation, the velocity of the y direction is constant, so x equal to v0 into t, and from that t equal to x by v0x. Now substituting the value of t in the displacement equation, y gives y equal to, after all of this, y equal to half Eym Vx square. From this equation, if you can replace this t, then you get this equation. After that, if you can derivative of that, then dy by dx, as you know that this is the tan theta. Now the tan theta, theta is, from that tan theta is equal to x by y is also your tan theta, and from that d is L into tan theta. And see that this is your d L into tan theta. Okay, this is L, this is d, this is your d divided by L, this is your tan theta. So you can see that d equal to L into tan theta, and from that we can say that the deflecting, substituting value, we can get that the deflection on the skin due to the y direction voltage only. So we get the deflection on the skin. The deflection is, you can see that this is the deflection due to the y direction movement or the y direction voltage applied. Electron can move like that. So this is your deflection. So you can see that d equal to, this is your final equation. Okay, thank you.